Later today, when Parliament sits, Meka Whaitiri will be greeted with a pōhiri by the Te Pāti Māori when she crosses the floor to formally join her new party. Since her shock resignation last Wednesday, the Ikaroa Rāwhiti MP hasn't spoken publicly about why she left Labour and why she didn't inform her colleagues, including the Prime Minister, of her decision. In an exclusive breakfast interview, Jenny May is with the former Labour MP and Te Pāti Māori co-leader Rāwhiti Whaitiri. Morena, Jenny May.
Morena, Chris. Morena kia koutou katoa. Morena kia kōrua. Thank you both so much for being with breakfast this morning. First of all, Meka, this is a little bit different, your office, to what you've been used to over the last few years.
Welcome to my my office. Yeah, it's very cosy, as you can see.
Not much to it. Meka, I want to ask you about why you left Labour.
It's always been a calling of mine. You know, coming to a place like Wellington so many years ago, the messages my grandmother came is why you come to Wellington, to learn how Wellington operates, the tool of the Pākehā, to turn around to help and aid your people. It's been my calling. It's been my calling to return back to an unapologetically Māori party.
What is it about the Labour Party that made you cross the floor, though, to Te Pāti Māori, and why now, 5 months out from the general election?
Actually, it was a calling deep in my puku that I had to do this. The timing was right for me and my whānau. And we made the decision and, you know, here we are.
There'll be people listening to this going, that's not a reason. Was there a policy within Labour that you absolutely didn't agree with? Was there a policy in Te Pāti Māori that you felt that's where you need to be pushing that agenda?
Our people will understand the actions I've taken. It wasn't an easy one, Jenny May, but it was deep within my puku and within my ngākau to return to Te Pāti Māori, who unashamedly are Māori. It is a calling that was very strong to me, and as discussed with my whānau, this is the decision we've made. Many of your viewers may not understand that, but as a Māori, they will understand that calling, that beckoning, who we are as Māori, our tikanga, our whakapapa, and that's what was calling me. And the timing was right for me and my whānau, and I've made that decision.
This is about Māori intellect. Not a Pākehā intellect. So Pākehā intellect will come from here. Her Māori intellect comes from her ngākau and her puku. And so you'll understand that, Jenny May, when you, on your journey to learn your reo, you followed your Māori intellect, you followed your Māori puku and your ngākau to have that connection with your whakapapa. And that's what Mika has done, is gone back to her whakapapa.
Can I talk about why you didn't connect with any of your Māori caucus? Why you didn't tell the Prime Minister personally of your decision to leave?
So in this place, trust is really hard gained and easily lost. My whānau have been the bedrock of everything I've done all my life, including being in this place. Tikanga Māori says you go back to your trusted sources, and I did that with my own whānau. I did that with my wider supporters. Mm. I did that with my cousin Heather Te Aue Skipworth, yes. And I did that with the marae. And I did let the President of the New Zealand Party know of my decision.
So tikanga would also say that you have colleagues within the Māori caucus who have stood by you through the ups and downs over the years. And my understanding is that they're hurt. Some of them are angry as well that there was no connection with them about your decision.
Like I said, this was a whānau decision, and I went back to my trusted sources, and we made this decision that was best in our interest.
Why couldn't you go to the Prime Minister? He's your boss.
Yep, so like I said, trusted sources, timing, tikanga, and I prioritised who I needed to let know, and I did inform the President of the party. So I let them know when the decision was final. And I did that last Wednesday morning.
Do you not trust the Prime Minister?
No, I trust my family.
In terms of the Māori caucus, Willie Jackson, who's the co-chair of the caucus, told Q&A on Sunday that he felt that you probably went to Te Pāti Māori because you were passed over for a position in Cabinet. Is there any truth in that? He also says that he felt like he let you down and that the caucus let you down.
No, it's not even about Willie or all my former colleagues. this Jenny May to say yet again is my journey. It's my whakapapa, it's my responsibility as a Māori to return back to a political movement that unashamedly is proud to be Māori. That's my natural fit, and there was always going to be come a time where I would transition back to who I am as a Māori.
When you made the announcement last week, there was talk about being unshackled, there was talk about emancipation. Did you feel shackled within Labour?
I didn't feel I was heard. I've now joined a party that I know my voice and those I represent will be heard.
I want to go back to what we initially talked about in terms of the Prime Minister. You said that you trust those within your whānau. And you said you didn't trust the Prime Minister. Why not?
No, I didn't say I didn't trust the Prime Minister. That's what you said, Jenny May. What I said is I went to my trusted sources. My whānau has given 23 long, loyal years of service to the Labour Party. They were Parakura's campaign team for 13 years. They're my campaign team for 10. We have done the right thing by ourselves, putting our whakapapa first, and I'm not going to apologise about that.
27 years, that seat hasn't been flipped. It's been staunchly Labour in Ikaroa Rāwhiti. Do you think, Meka, coming across to Te Pāti Māori, that can happen at this next election?
Well, that's where the shackles quarter all comes in that you just talked about, Jenny May, is that, yes, it has been shackled with the Labour Party since 1943, to be quite honest. Broken once by New Zealand First and gone back to Labour. I think this is an opportunity for Te Ikaroa Rāwhiti and a strong opportunity to have an unapologetic voice here in Parliament for the very first time. And like Meka has said, she'll continue to be the advocates for Ikaroa Rāwhiti, Pautaka. And we're looking forward to the election. We're looking forward to what Meka brings to the kaupapa.
Meka, my understanding is that the Māori caucus reached out to you. They wanted to meet with you. They wanted to clear the air about everything for you to be able to talk to them about the why. Why did you turn that down?
Actually, what was on offer was a karakia. And I have done that with my people on my marae. And I responded respectfully that resetting of my wairua, that restoring of my wairua has been done in a tikanga Māori way with my whānau, with my iwi on our marae.
This next question is a really important one because it speaks to whether you should still be an MP, albeit independent, within Parliament. When you made the announcement last week, you said, I have officially notified the Speaker that I have resigned from the Labour Party and that I am joining Te Pāti Māori. Now, the Speaker said he received communication that your vote would no longer be cast with the Labour Party and that you wanted to be seated with Te Pāti Māori. This has been a little bit of a mess in terms of what has happened since then. So, which one was it? Did you send the message to say that you had resigned?
No, I, just like the Speaker said, I sent him a letter and he ruled accordingly. What I said to my people on my marae is my truth. This is where people are getting a bit confused and calling it messy. It's not messy. For the parliamentary purposes, I wrote to the Speaker. He ruled accordingly. End of story.
So that what you wrote to him was not that you had resigned, but that you were crossing to Te Pāti
Māori? I wrote to him, like he read the letter out, literally, in the House, that I had removed my vote from the Labour whip and my desire was to sit next to Te Pāti Māori. That is a parliamentary process, and that's why I did what I did. And, you know, people will call it messy. It's quite not. What I told our people on the marae is absolutely the truth. This is my intention, and I wanted to be honest with my people.
So there's kōrero that you potentially have withdrawn any correspondence that went to the Speaker or someone within Te Pāti Māori?
No, I wrote to the Speaker after seeking his advice, because he is there to seek to provide advice for MPs. His office provided very good advice, and I wrote accordingly, and he made his ruling.
What will it be like when you cross the floor this morning? Because there's going to be a pōhiri, right? So what will that moment be like for you?
Be like coming home, in a political sense. This place is in an extremely challenging place for any Māori. To know that you have people and colleagues who are tikanga bound, who will support and afi you. That helps the challenges of this place, helps you manage it. And so I'll be looking forward to crossing the floor with my colleagues, with Rawiri and Debbie, for a movement that I 100% believe in, as does my whānau.
Mm-hmm. Rawiri, I've been told to wrap up, but I do want to come to you finally and ask about what will happen today in Parliament.
What will happen is you won't see it again for a long time, and you haven't seen it before. And so we are re-indigenising this space, not only the decolonisation of ourselves, but the re-indigenisation of the space. And so we will do it very Māori. That would be my answer.
Well, tēnei te mihi atu ki a kōrua, i a kōrua, kōrero i tātanei. Thank you both so much for your kōrero this morning. So I will now be heading straight down to where the Prime Minister is to get the Prime Minister to respond to this morning's kōrero. So I'll see you again shortly.
Kia ora, Jenny.